One of the main priorities of Vladimir Putin is to turn around the demographic development that has tormented Eastern Europe for decades, shrinking populations caused by emigration and low fertility rates. On the surface, Russia has succeeded in the last few years, but a closer look at the numbers show that they still point to what would be a grim future for the whole region. By the start of the 20th century, every Russian woman gave birth to, on average, 7 children. But the child mortality was high. Close to half of the children did not survive their 5th birthday. The birth rates fluctuate significantly in the first half of the 20th century, with clear dips around World War I and the Revolution, and during World War II. By 1950, the fertility rate stabilizes, around 3 babies born per woman. The child mortality was still high. 170 out of 1,000 children died before the age of 5. Today, no country in the world has a child mortality that high. In 1950, the population of Russia was 102 million. While the population slowly grew, the fertility rate dropped to around point of reproduction, or slightly below, at the end point of the Cold War. By then, the population had risen to 147 million. Following the fall of the Soviet Union in the early 1990s, the fertility rate of Russian women fell fast and dropped below point of reproduction. By the start of the new millennium, when Putin rose to power, they were down to levels almost unseen before in the world, with women giving birth to only 1.2 or 1.3 babies on average. The economic crash and health systems falling apart meant that young people were leaving through the country's more translucent borders than ever, seeking work and education opportunities abroad. The mortality rates rose, higher than the birth rates, and Russia went into population decline for 15 years straight, 1993 to 2008, partly due to low fertility rates, partly due to a large group of the population born in the 1920s till the early 1940s dying. Even though Russia has lost a lower percentage of their workforce population to emigration than other smaller Eastern European nations, millions of younger people have left the country in the last couple of decades, a clear majority of them having a higher education. The largest migration flows goes to Western Europe and Northern America. Even though the actual losses associated with emigration of this type can be further nuanced, highly educated people who are out of work do not generally contribute as much to the economy of the country of origin as they do to the destination country. This is especially true in a nation like Russia, where the wage differences between skilled and unskilled occupations are smaller than in other nations. With that said, a shrinking working age population supporting a larger, older generation is a recipe for economic troubles ahead. Efforts put in place to reduce the population loss has slowed down the process. Economic support for parents has increased, and an extra bonus is paid to women having a second child. But the 1.7 or 1.8 children per woman today is still not enough to secure replacement of the current population. Improvements in child mortality has been seen since the late 1990s, dropping to close to a third of what it was 20 years ago. Today, 6.8 children per 1,000 born die before the age of 5, only slightly higher than the 6.5 of the United States. While the western parts of Russia is generally well populated, the further east and the further north you go, the more sparsely populated it gets. The vast surface of Siberia acts as a great protection from invading armies and hold large natural resources for the nation. But the cost of infrastructure investments in the furthermost regions mean that there are regional differences in economic opportunities and health prospects. The fertility rate is also varying across the country. While the low levels are still prevalent in the western parts of the nation, higher fertility rates can be found in poorer regions out east, as well as in regions with a differing ethnical composition than the majority of the nations, such as in Chechnya and Ingushetia in the Caucasus, as well as in Tuva and Altai along the Russian Kazakh and the Russian-Mongolian border. In the next video, we will focus more specifically on the health aspects impacting the Russian demographics.